Let's get started and let's start our discovery journey. And let me welcome very heartedly our president of the European Patent Office, Antonio Campinos.
It's fascinating because it's a game changer. It changes the rules of the game. It basically transforms consumers into producers.
Additive manufacturing will provide a great opportunity to participate in an emerging new economic model with decentralized production and distribution.
I see a huge potential in this technology to foster sustainability, both environmental and social sustainability.
We have, so to say, the tools of law to make sure that we can take the ethical aspects and the societal aspects into consideration.
Is the IP system fit for purpose as it stands? That's a question that the European Commission has asked and answered in a report in February.
Europe is leading. So we have, more or less, we represent for Europe 47% of the total of applications, and the remaining being divided in US, Japan. And the trend in terms of patents filed is accelerating as I speak.
We are only seeing the beginning of innovation in those sectors, and that there is much more to come in the coming years.
What are the main criteria you look at for investing?
It's the team that generates a company and applies the tools and the knowledge that they have gained. And hopefully, that's the second criterion, it's backed by solid IP.
We absolutely need standardization of IP all over the world.
They are global, and we need to help them scale up. And that's why we liaise with the other offices worldwide to harmonize.
We are still only in the first hour of the first day of 3D manufacturing.
We designed the Charlotte valve. This is these yellow pieces that attached on the top of the mask can convert a traditional snorkeling mask into a respiratory one. Through here pass oxygen, and then this is the outlet, and with a filter you can use it on a COVID patient.
It turns out everybody has the same story. They have an idea, they have an invention, they have to sacrifice themselves to get that idea implemented in the world.
The IP system is coping well with additive manufacturing. It's clearly fit for purpose. However, some adaptations and alignment may be required in the future. The debate will continue, I'm sure.